Hello everyone, today I am going to discuss about exception handling in Java. What is exception and what is exception hierarchy, how can you handle an exception and how can you design your own exception. These are our main objectives in today's lecture. What is an exception and error? There are basically two types of error, compile time and runtime. Compile time errors are those errors which can be detected by the compiler. For example, missing semicolon, missing brackets, some you have declared undeclared variables. And runtime errors are those errors in which your program will compile successfully but corresponding dot class file is not created in case of Java. For example, you have division by zero issues, error index out of bounds. For example, you can see here we have missing semicolon. Now these types of errors are detected at the compile time. Now next case of exception, like here we are finding the value of b 10 divided by 0. Now it will throw an exception at the runtime. It is not checked at the compile time. Now these types of runtime errors are known as exception. Each exception is specified by some name. Now exception can be defined that it is an abnormal condition which arises at code sequence at the runtime. So basically it is considered as a runtime error. So your programming language must provide some support to handle these types of exception. Java provides support to handle these types of exception with the help of 5 keywords. Now all these 5 keywords are basically derived from an inbuilt class known as throwable. In the next slide, we will see its exception hierarchy. Now this diagram shows the exception hierarchy. At the top, you have an object class. At the other end, we have another subclass that is known as a throwable. Now this throwable class is further divided into two categories, exceptions and error. Exception is further classified into two categories, checked and unchecked, and error further includes so many exceptions which are not handled by the programmer. Throwable class include two categories, exception and error. Exception includes further two subcategories, checked and unchecked. Checked exceptions are basically those exceptions which are checked by the programmer at the compile time. For example, file that you want to open is not available. Class not found, illegal access exception, no such field exception. These types of exceptions are known as checked exceptions. Means you can check these exceptions at the compile time also. And unchecked, which we are not checking at the compile time, they are checked at the runtime. For example, null pointer issues, arithmetic exceptions, array index issues. And error exceptions are those exceptions which are not recoverable during the programming. For example, out of memory error, virtual machine error, session errors. So in these examples, we are dealing with only this type of category of checked and unchecked exceptions. Checked and unchecked exceptions are handled with the help of these 5 keywords. Now first keyword is the try. Try keyword used to monitor the block of code for error, and corresponding there is a handler that is known as a catch, which specify which type of exception you are handling. And another keyword is finally, that always execute whether exception is generated or not. So your program must consist of try, catch, or try or finally block of code. Now see this example. In this example we are finding the value of b, and corresponding there is a handler catch. Now you can see here sample output, here value of b is not printed. It is not printed because when an exception is written at this line, it will throw an exception, and your program is looking for the corresponding handler where to handle this exception. Now it is handled at this point, and corresponding statements division by zero and after catch statement is printed. This line is not printed in any case when an exception is generated. Next case, you can nest multiple try and catch statements also. Like in this example, we are finding the value of number of arguments passed by the user at the runtime. If the number of arguments is set to 1, then again it is generating a case of division by 0. If the number of arguments is set to 2, then it is generating a case of array index out of bounds. And corresponding, you can specify the description of the exception with the help of catch. It must be corresponding to the exception which is generated in the program. This is the sample output. If the number of argument is 0 or 1, then arithmetic exception. If it is 2 arguments, then array index out of bounds. Next is throw keyword. Throw keyword used to throw an exception explicitly by the user. Now how to throw an exception? In order to throw an exception, we have to create an object of throwable class. Now, in order to create the object, we use new keyword and then corresponding name of the exception, and this is a optional parameter. Now, when you throw an exception, corresponding you must be having a catch block which will handle this corresponding exception. Now, this program is catching the exception and then re-throwing the exception. Now, in main method, when you are calling this demo method, first it is throwing the exception, then catching the exception, and then re-throwing the exception. So, we are using catch block two times. First catch and then second re-catch. Now this is the sample output inside static method, caught inside demo, and then re-caught with full description of the exception. This demo is the same which we passed as a parameter in your null pointer exception. Next is the use of throws keyword. Now this throw keyword is used to list the type of exception which a method can throw when it is called. For example, we have a demo method. Now when this demo method is called, here it is throwing illegal exception. Now corresponding you have a catch block. Now you can see here we are using throws and here we are using throw keyword. Now it will clarify the difference between throw and throws. Throw is used to throw an exception explicitly, and throws will list the number of exceptions that a method can throw. Now it will generate this type of output inside throw one, and then corresponding caught, and E is showing the description of the exception, that is actually exception object. Next, the use of finally keyword. Finally is a dead block of code that always execute whether there is exception generated or not. Your program must consist of try catch block or try or finally block. Now this example, we have a try and finally, then again we have a try and finally for two different methods A and B, and corresponding we are throwing an exception here, and here we are simply returning an exception. Now when we call these two methods A and B in the main, and corresponding there is a catch block, it will generate this type of output. Inside A, that is corresponding to a try block, this is corresponding to your finally block, and then it is moving to the catch block. You can see here this one inside A, then A is finally, and then exception caught, then corresponding execution of inside B and B is finally. Now all these are five keywords: try, catch, throw, throws, and finally, through which you can easily manage an exception in Java. Now let us pause for a second. Now we are going to move to create a user-defined exception. Now how to create a user-defined exception? In order to create a user-defined exception, simply you have to create a subclass of the exception class. Then you have to override the predefined methods provided by the exception class, which is, now why we are overriding the method, because when you are creating your own exception, you must provide the description of exception corresponding to user defined messages. Now let us take an example. You want to create an exception that will occur if the marks of the student is less than 18 in any of the five subjects. Means we have a five subjects, and we are taking the case if the marks of the student less than 18 in any five subject, then it will throw an exception. If the marks is greater than 18, then there will be no exception. Now first case, you will create a class that is extended from the exception class. Then you will pass its constructor, that is a string message. Now why this super keyword is used? This super keyword is used to override the super class constructor. Now here we are overriding the by default message string which your JVM system throws. Now in your main class, we are passing five variables A, B, C, D, E that are getting the values of five subjects marks. Here we are using parseInt method. This parseInt method is converting the value into integer format, and then we are storing into five variables. Next, we specify the conditions. What is the condition? Corresponding to that, we are throwing the exception. Here, use of throw keyword, and then corresponding there is a catch block. This get message method used to print the description of the message. And finally, you can use here finally block if you want to end the exception. Now you can practice various questions. These are sample questions. Now all these examples are basically taken from a complete reference books. Thank you all. Thank you for listening. I hope you will understand something about exception handling and how to manage exception, exception hierarchy, and regarding how to create a user-defined exception. Thank you for listening. Thank you.